It's not what you look at that matters, it's what you see. And when it comes to our children, it's the hopes of seeing their innocence, their desire for love and attention, and our guidance so that they can reach their fullest potential and succeed. But the fact of the matter is, today's kids are actually fighting for their lives.
Every 84 minutes, a child is abused or neglected.
In 2010, 62.8% of victims of abuse or neglect in the U.S. suffer from neglect alone.
You know, there are so many things in this area that could be fixed, but this really gets to the heart of it because people are literally seeing what's going on and how they can stop it.
Every 6 days, a child aged 19 or younger is murdered.
We're trying to raise awareness for Child Abuse Prevention Month, and the signs around here tell people what they can do if they know of a child who might be a victim of child abuse and stuff we can do to help them. And the pinwheels kind of represent like a child because, you know, they're like toys, so it'll, you know, attract people's attention.
This is the second year that we've done it. Last year, the idea came and, you know, we weren't sure how it was gonna go. We started off with about 25 of these little wooden people and about 500 pinwheels. And believe it or not, it took off, and this year has gotten bigger. We're hoping that next year gets bigger and bigger. And as a result of what we did here last year, Chesapeake is doing it, and there's a community up in Northern Virginia. They wanted information on how to do it. So we just want everybody to see what we're doing, to see the message and to get excited and to really think about children. And they're our future, and we need to protect them until they can protect themselves.
You know, every child is a precious gift full of promise and potential and deserves to be loved, cared for, nurtured, and to feel secure and free from neglect and abuse. We are here this evening to open the Silent Children's Garden and to renew our commitment to protecting our children.
Our grandson was shaken at the age of 6 weeks. He lived to be a little over 3 years old. Due to his initial brain injury, he was at MCV Hospital for 4.5 months. He had cerebral palsy, epilepsy, cortical visual impairment, scoliosis, pseudomonas, osteoporosis, all from the initial brain injury. He passed away on December 11, 2009. And for people who have lost their children to abuse, there's nothing that ever fills that hole. So when events like this happen, you are honored to be included, because if we can help save one child, then it's worth it.